One of the things that I love about being alive is that we get to discover the wonders of the world. And you know what? Today we are going to look to the skies and we're going to find out more about the billions of stars in the galaxy. And luckily for us, we get to hang out with a very, very cool stargazing enthusiast. No, not this one. This one's probably gone to the moon, but no, I'm not talking to him. I'm talking to another cool kid. Now, he's going to share with us a really, really interesting story about the solar system. And in fact, he might even share with us the secrets of the universe. Don't you go anywhere, because this is a place where we get to hang out with some of the coolest kids of Malaysia. This is Kid Zoners. I'm gonna introduce you to my buddy, Marcus! Get in here, come on, man, come on, come on, come on, come on, come here. What's up, how are you today?
Fine.
Very good, very good. Okay, now, could you tell us, like, you know, what was your journey into astronomy?
When I was 3 years old, my mother introduced me to the solar system, and as my interest grew in astronomy, I began to expand my interest into other stuff, like basically any stuff that's related to astronomy, like black holes, aliens, finding habitable exoplanets, sun, and many others.
Oh my goodness, you said like all those things that I'm just finding it incredibly like whoosh for me to understand, because, you know, the universe is such a vast thing, like what you said, like they're aliens. Do you think they're aliens?
Yeah, I do.
All right, I like this guy. Okay, so tell me, who influenced you to, you know, really like astronomy?
Since my mother was the one who first introduced me to the solar system, and she was also the one who actually went to search for activities, clubs and groups that are related to astronomy, she found the Astronomical Society of Penang about 3 years ago. The president and founder was Dr. Chong, who also began to support me and influence me to join astronomical activities.
Wow, that is intense. And how old are you again?
11.
Wow. Now, can you just sort of tell me, how do you think that we can promote astronomy to our friends? Because it's such an interesting topic.
We can promote astronomy by presentation, because that's how I do it. And I actually presented 10 times in 7 different schools. Ooh. And in 1 observatory. But other than presentation, you can also help promote by joining other astronomical activities and sharing your knowledge with your friends in these activities.
Tell me more about the solar system. What's that about?
The solar system is a planetary system that has 8 planets and the star. The star, which is of course our sun, is in the middle, and with the 8 planets, including the Earth, orbiting around it. But the solar system doesn't only consist of the 8 planets and the sun. It also consists of other materials such as dust, gas, the asteroid belts, the Kuiper belt, the dwarf planets, comets, meteors, asteroids, and many others.
Oh, well, okay, all right, hang on a second. You said 8 planets in our solar system, right?
Yeah.
When I was in school, I learned that there were 9. What happened to the last one?
The last one was Pluto, but soon scientists actually declassified it and changed its status into a dwarf planet.
I think that's really unfair. I feel really sorry for Pluto. But anyways, no, that's besides the point. But so you have a liking or an interest in finding another Earth-like planet, is that correct?
Yeah.
So could you tell us why it would be a good thing to find another Earth-like planet for humans to live in?
I never thought it was a good thing. I watched like a lot of Star Wars, Star Trek and all that. So in my mind, it was like a super advanced human civilization going to like invade and colonize other planets. But besides that, I was also curious to see whether aliens really exist or not. And another reason is because we are slowly destroying this planet piece by piece. How? Through polluting the atmosphere, the beaches, and many other places. So one of the ways to preserve the human race and keep it from being extinct is to, of course, find another habitable planet for us to live on.
That's what I'm talking about, guys. You gotta make sure that the planet is all good in the hood. I cannot stress it. You gotta high five me on this one. Oh, yeah. See, now, that's the part where we kind of want to avoid. We don't want to actually have to find another planet to live on. But it's because sometimes as humans, we're kind of messing things up a little bit. Let's stop doing that now, shall we? From what I heard, you have started speaking about astronomy to people, right?
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit more about that.
Dr. Zhang, which is the founder of the ASP, was the one who first gave us the idea of actually presenting out my astronomy knowledge to others. So my first presentation was supposed to be in a Gemini meteor shower event organized by the ASP. But due to a time rush, the presentation was actually cancelled. So I suggested to my mother, why not we actually do a presentation in my previous school, SJKC Zhonghua Busan. And so, with the help and support of my parents, Dr. Chong, and a very supportive headmistress, we managed to present on SJKC Zhonghua Busan on January 18, 2018.
Well done, you, my friend.
Listening to this kid, I'm already like, wow. I'm telling you, mate, this is insane how much you already know at such a tender age of 11. Now, okay, so I'm just gonna ask you one last question, especially for someone like me who kind of wants to start looking into this because you've made it incredibly interesting. Can you make your own telescope?
Yeah, I can.
Can you teach me how to make a telescope?
Yeah, I can.
Awesome sauce, and that's why he's gonna live long and prosper.
But I can't put too much as it will leak.
Gotta get the terms right, kids.
Okay, so we are done.
All right, so we already covered it.
Now we will need to use hot glue gun to actually stick this lens in.
Mm-hmm.
So that it's easier. And then we use hot glue gun, put it around, take the tape off, and wrap the tape around.
I see.
I have one ready-made one here.
Yep.
And as you can see, there's tape around it. And there's also glue behind the tape.
Okay. What is that? Is that cardboard?
Yeah, that's cardboard.
I see, okay.
And then you're going to squeeze the eyepiece in. And then, normally I would cut it into half, but since the small tube can fit in here.
Right.
Yeah, since the normal tube can fit in here, I do not need to cut in. So, you just use the glue gun, you stick it around, put it on, and then use glue gun and just shoot it around.
Okay, but so, you've already made one already,
yeah,
right?
Also,
okay, so I'm gonna put
I've
this
also,
aside
I'm,
over here.
I've already made one.
Okay.
And there we go, we have done it.
Wow.
So I have a completely ready-made telescope over here, as you can see, and it works perfectly well.
Okay, let me see. Oh yeah, you're right. Everybody looks upside down right now. Hey, I see someone's feet. Thank you so much for showing us how to make that telescope, Marcus.
You're welcome.
All right, well, you know what? Seeing as the fact that you are so awesome and you decided to share the little secrets for us to actually discover more about the universe, we want to give you a little gift. So I'm going to call my buddy Don. There you go.
Thank you.
All right, I hope you enjoy that bag. Who knows what you might be able to keep in there? Your mini telescopes, your giant telescopes, and all sorts of stuff. But anyways, for the rest of you who are really, really interested in finding out more about the universe, make sure you find an astronomy club near you. And in fact, why don't you try and follow him? Find out how he's doing it. Go online, go on YouTube and check things out, okay? But for now, make sure you stick around to Kids Zoners. There's so much more in store for you today. In the meantime, from Marcus and I, live long and prosper. Welcome back to Kids Zoners. Now, we want to talk about a very interesting activity that you could find in school. It is called choral speaking. Now, if you're wondering what it is, well, I promise you it is not about you talking to corals under the sea. That's the sort of stuff that I do. No. Choral speaking is basically when there are a group of people who get together and recite a poem in a synchronized manner. It almost sounds like it's a speaking choir. And luckily for us today, we have the girls from SK Convent Bukit, Mertajam, and they're gonna talk to us about choral speaking. Say hi, ladies.
Hi.
Ooh, I love the energy. It's like, who run the world, girls? Yes. How did you join choral speaking?
Audition.
You audition? Okay, you audition. How about you? You audition?
Audition too.
You audition as well. So basically the sign was put up and someone said join the choral speaking group and then you decided to audition. Everyone auditioned as well.
Yes.
So is choral speaking a big thing in your school?
Yes.
Ooh, these are the cool kids I'm hanging out with. Very, very nice. Okay, well, I take it you guys have joined competitions before?
Yes.
Have you won anything?
Yes.
Ooh, I love it. I love it. So it is. Is this within the state or within the country?
International.
International. International champions. I love it. Okay, I'm really, really looking forward to seeing this more, like especially when you guys are going to perform for us. But is it difficult to do choral speaking?
No.
No? No? I mean, what is your experience on this?
The teacher in charge will ask us to scream so that she can know how loud is our voice.
So you're like, that's how loud I can go. But is it difficult to memorize all of the words?
No.
Where do you usually get your poems from? Do you know?
From the teacher.
From the teacher.
From the teacher. All from the, everything is from the teachers. All right, very, very good. How do you think, choral speaking, how has it benefited you?
It can improve my English. Mm-hmm. I can get more friends.
Ah, so you guys are all besties right now?
Yeah.
Do you get to travel a lot when it comes to competitions? So don't you go anywhere, because this is a choral speaking group from SK Convent Bukit Mertajam.
When the sun descends into its drowsy sleep, the dawn fades as the darkness arouses. The journey of life begins. Token of warmth and happiness are taken away. We, the girls from the gold chamber, proudly present a mysterious, creepy, eerie, spooky, dark, gloomy, seductive chorus speaking entitled Beliefs Beyond Boundaries.
I don't believe in superstitions, especially ghosts.
Check.
Superstitions is an irrational fear of what is unknown or mysterious.
No, it is a strict practice that must be respected by you and you and all of you. Whatever, we are modern people. Follow Western style, yeah. For instance, we Asians strongly believe that consuming pineapples during pregnancy should be avoided. No, no, as it will harm the baby.
Oh, no!
Huh? Agu-gu-cha!
Cannot sing in the kitchen.
La 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 la.
You die low. Later, you will marry an old man. How? Ayo-yo.
I tell a lady, don't open the umbrella in the house.
Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer. Yes. All these are the predictions that are made based on our birth chart. So, what is your horoscope sign?
Monkey!
Ha!
Who's the fuck?
Ha!
Tiger! Whoa!
It's Gemini!
They say I will get married with Justin Bieber by this weekend.
Ooh la la, Justin Bieber, woo! These superstitions have always been lingering around us. But do you think they exist? Are they all just beliefs? Draw your own conclusions, ladies and gentlemen, as beliefs are beyond boundaries. Thank you.
I do want to give you ladies a little gift, so you're going to help me call my buddy Idan on a count of three. One, two, three.
Idan!
Come, come, come. Thank you very much. Now I'm going to give you one bag. One bag only for all of you to share. This one you guys have to figure out how you're going to share it. I'm kidding. Everyone's going to get a bag, obviously. But yes, anyway, so thank you so much for hanging out with us this Saturday at Kids Zoners. In fact, stick around to TV2 because there's so much more in store for you. And if you want to find out more about these girls, well, you know what? Find us on our social media. Find out the details below. And of course, don't forget to catch us again next week right here on Kids Zoners. Bye!
Bye!